Iron is a mineral that's super important to your health, and iron deficiency is the most common nutritional deficiency in the US. In this video, I'll show you how iron works, how to take iron tablets, and how to reduce the side effects that iron supplements can cause. So stay tuned until the end. All of your cells contain some iron, but most of the iron in your body is actually in your red blood cells. It helps our muscles store and use oxygen, which is what essentially gives you life. It's also part of a very important protein in our body called hemoglobin, which helps carry oxygen from our lungs to the rest of our body. And when we don't have enough iron, these functions can slow down, leaving us to feel weak and fatigued, making it harder to maintain our body temperatures. It can decrease immune function and can even cause iron deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia happens when our bodies have an increased need for iron, like in pregnancy, if you have a poor absorption of the iron itself, or in the case if you are a vegetarian and have to rely on only non-heme sources of iron from plants, or if you had major blood loss. In any case, if you are taking iron supplements available in either capsules, tablets, or chewables, and even liquids, the most common one being ferrous sulfate at 325 milligrams, there are some important tips that you should know that can help you make the best use of that iron correctly. So first things first, iron is best absorbed on an empty stomach. Food can heavily decrease its absorption. Milk, calcium, high fiber foods, caffeine, and antacids should not be taken at the same time. A good rule of thumb is to take it 1 hour before you eat or 2 hours after you eat. Research also shows that if you take your iron supplement with a drink containing vitamin C, like orange juice, it can actually help improve the absorption. Red bell peppers actually have 3 times more vitamin C than an orange. Fun fact. Second thing you should watch for is that iron tablets may cause other drugs you are taking to not work as well. These include tetracyclines, penicillins, and ciprofloxacin, and drugs used for hypothyroidism, Parkinson's disease, and seizures. So talk to your doctor or pharmacist, letting them know that you are on iron supplements before you take any of these. Thirdly, let's say you start taking iron on an empty stomach, but it leaves you with some stomach pain, constipation, and diarrhea, and feeling sick. The good thing is that this will go away on its own over time when your body gets used to it, but if it doesn't, your doctor can lower the dose and work its way up slowly to the preferred level, or they can switch to a different iron supplement. If you still feel discomfort, speak to your doctor to see if it's okay to take it with a small bit of food to avoid these side effects. Fourthly, iron supplements can have side effects, so besides stomach discomfort, constipation, diarrhea, nausea, or vomiting, it can leave your stool looking black, which is normal as it may be a sign that the tablets are working correctly. It can be alarming at first, but don't be worried. With that being said, if your stool is tarry, has red streaks in it, let your doctor know then to go from there. Also, liquid forms of iron can stain your teeth, so try mixing the iron with water or other liquids like orange juice and drinking the medicine with a straw. Just don't try drinking orange juice after brushing your teeth. It's a weird aftertaste. Anyways, I digress. Overall though, most people respond well to taking iron supplements, and your levels should return to normal after 2 months of iron therapy for most people. But you may need to continue taking supplements for another 6 to 12 months to build up the body's iron stores in the bone marrow. Never hesitate to ask your doctor or pharmacist how long you should be taking them, or if you have any questions at all. Now you're an iron supplement pro. Let me know if this video was useful to you in the comments below. If you learned something new or had any more questions, I love getting back to you guys. So make sure you like the video and subscribe to stay on board for all my other health videos I have coming out for you guys. And as always, see you on the next one.